Thanks, everybody. We've been working here for the last one. My name is Brad Ascar. I'm with Red Hat, and I'm a field product manager for PowerPoints. I may interchangeably use ManageIQ and PowerPoints, but my brain still can't keep those two separate. About 30 to 7:30 in the weekends. Get a couple of rent tickets, some very important stuff. Okay. So we're going to jump in to things on system management. Policy is one of those things that is really very powerful in the system. And there's so many use cases for it. But it requires you to kind of stop and step back a little bit and think about how do you propose these things. So the power in it is that it's a small discrete transaction. The power is just not going to be a large one. So they don't want to be a big thing there. Different people have different view about what policy management is. ManageIQ policy can be categorized in three buckets. You can add these in your own case. That's the other part of this, is that you don't have to go in and create a ton of policy right away. You can totally automate your environment. People don't really worry about that. So starting out with, you can just start with alerts, right? So you want to know what things happen in your environment, and you want somebody to get an email. Because you're just testing this thing out, you don't really know what it works. You want to learn like stuff, shutting the system down, finding this, kind of what goes on there. Compliance is another place you can do it. So the regulatory kinds of things, pass, fail, and notifying groups if there's something not being policy, those sorts of things. And then ultimately, you can get out of policy enforcement where you're actually remediating or stopping policy movements from happening inside of the environment. Most people, when they first get in, they're really looking at provisioning, they're really looking at all those kind of things. Policy is really what you start rounding out for the rest of your environment and really starts taking some of the work out of the system. Drive some efficiency. The other piece of policy is you can determine where you want to apply this. Like you can say, I want policy because I've got a dev environment, and I don't want to really want to have a policy that somebody can't do something, whatever. You can apply policy at whatever level you want within the environment. And then you can also use that in conjunction with tagging to really narrow down what you're doing. An example would be a policy profile in production cluster that only gets workloads tagged for it, right? So you don't worry about any of the other policy because that's really the only thing you care about. And really, with the use cases, really what they're looking for, you want to try to protect your environment from whatever incorrect baseline is. That's going to be different for everybody else. There's too many kinds of things that you're concerned about. Apply policy in there. But it can be very different depending on your organization, depending on regulatory kind of things you are, and where you live. So let's look at start to look at control. And that's really the control part of the ManageIQ system. We're going to give an example. We're going to use a policy to simply stop a virtual machine if it breaks policy for whatever reason. It could be that somebody is running something really you don't want to think about. You might have a policy that says if something shows up in the environment and it doesn't have at least X tags, right, which can only be mentioned in by certain groups, you stop it from starting. Those are the kinds of things you do. And then maybe you want to go to the help desk, the security team, or something else that really wants you not to got talking a little bit more earlier about events, conditions, and actions. We have all around PCA, and you can conditionally process these things. Right? So let's look at the previous use case. Don't allow more than one gig on PMC based workloads. Solution would be the event would be that the box policy of the event would be reconfigured, and have to see a reconfigured hardware or stolen. This one is specifically on reconfigure, but if you think about it, it actually needs frequency on the workload. How can something end up in this container like that? The condition is this VM in a VMZ? Is it a count one or one? And then if both of them are true, execute an action, you have a security team. Better yet, cancel the event in the endpoint because you don't want that action to happen. So because we're listening on the bus, we know that this event happened. So, start off with events. Events are finite. This isn't all of them. As the product progresses, they add a few more here and there. It's not just in the daily event. But there's a finite number of events. So, events are the events for a provider. I think John was talking about it. We have 100 on the VM, 100 on the VM, right? And that gets enhanced. I mean, we've actually talked to some of these providers and said, hey, we really need these additional things, right? And that's the power of the Red Hat has had to be one of the projects is we've got an easy way in to say, we really need these four other things because it makes management of all of us better for everybody. And then they can have those things. So we have a finite number of events available based on the providers and some of them within ManageIQ itself. So there are events that happen that are either synthetic events inside ManageIQ or they're a combination. That a combination of things happen and then we create one synthetic event because it's easier to those are the built-in rules. Like I said, that's an example of this. Actions are infinite. Now, there's a bunch of stuff that comes out of the box that you might want to do with something like that. You might want to do some sort of email thing. You may want to put OS in standby mode, delete VMs, any number of things you can do. But one of the things that you can do is call automation scripts. You can immediately go right to the template that you know your automation model and call that. So it's infinite number of things you do. Go to state machine, call a method directly. Like John said, and I'm a big proponent of it, pretty much everything. But it doesn't have anything connected. It's just one step calling something. And then eventually you may decide that, oh, I really should have done something else. I want to change this with something else. And then it just is easier if you've already done it at the state machine if you don't have the state machine. The other thing that I touched on, but when you do a state machine, you're writing any kind of code, the second you think that you need state. That's a little bit code smell for main state. You should never have when you have to sleep in your thing. Hope you pull me up and read it when you've got the range of state machine. Does that for you? Does it for you over retries? Does that for you over power failures or whatever's going on? Or you want those kinds of advantages? If you need to sleep, automate workflows, you can script anything. Conditions can really be anything. This is really where you start getting into the power of having a lot of information about what's in your environment. So you can have conditions of kind of VM hardware adapters over one. We talked about that one. Find a VM in here. If it has an OKV, these are the actual examples of things that we've done with PLCs where people say, hey, we want to make sure that these events happen, right? Or we want to check that for but find public variables, sure, check all kinds of things that we have brought in, reload the event, right? So we can make configuration files, we can create things like registry keys, find use cases. You think about the who needs these policies and what they're doing with them. Is it an IT department that needs certain things that are enforced in their environment? Maybe it's the performance team. Maybe they're looking at why there's something going on in their environment and they want to see what's going on in that environment. And to determine if everything's running the way it's supposed to be. There are a number of things that are out there that need policies that are best practices. want to know when those are in line with the things. So there's some good examples here. Really, thank you for that. Thank you. state machine to wake up every X amount of time, determine some value